Welcome back to Monday Night Raw. The late Chris Benoit, arguably one of the greatest world heavyweight champions our sport has ever seen. Right now we take it to comments from the reigning world heavyweight champion, the rated R superstar, Edge.
I have three people in this industry that I feel I can go to talk to. And two of them are gone now. I remember as a teenager watching Stampede Wrestling. I was in Toronto and I'd watch Stampede from Calgary, and I saw this 18-year-old guy named Chris Benoit start his career, and I thought, oh, that guy's awesome. He's gonna be something. And he became one of the greatest to ever put on a pair of boots. And I had the pleasure and the privilege to get in there with them, to, man, just knock heads with them. Anytime we got in there, it was like two Canadians fighting for the last beer. I had some personal issues in my own life, and he was the first person I went to because I knew I could trust him, and he cared. Didn't just pat me on the back. And that's more important than wrestling, is the person that I mean, everybody in this locker room loved Chris. You won't find one guy that had a bad thing to say about him. He carried himself with such pride and dignity, and took such pride in his work. About 2 weeks ago in Orlando, I once again had the privilege to get in the ring with Chris. And, man, as strange as it sounds to get kicked in the head that hard and chopped that hard, it was so much fun. And when we came through the gorilla position, he was smiling. And Chris didn't do that. He just got a standing ovation once we went off the air. And that, to me, was the biggest compliment in the world, is that he was smiling after a match. I just remember when I had my neck surgery, he was my guy that I called for advice. Is this normal? You know, am I supposed to tingle in my fingers? And he was always there. Two weeks ago as well, and we had a live event in Dothan, Alabama. And he came with Daniel, his son Daniel, and Daniel had a tie on in his dress shirt, which he always did when he came to the shows. And Chris was doing his warm-up exercises, and Daniel was doing them all with him. And I just thought how lucky he was. It's just really confusing. I don't understand things like this, and I don't know if I ever will. know he'd be hot on me right now for crying, but I can't help it because I just, I love that guy. I'm gonna miss him.